We had a few different from the Chiefs department.
What was up with you?
There was something about their 180-pound weightlifting father that they just didn't want to challenge.
But when he did,
I did a number of things. Now, I packed them on the bottom, or I held them there, or I took them up to their bedroom and put them in their crib, put them in their bed, because I wanted to make sure this guy is real. But this is what I would suggest you do, because you're a mom, and not a 180-pound weightlifting father who would be a little more imposing than a sweet mom. All right, Dr. A, be back.
Why would God permit the devil to tempt his son in the desert?
The symbol of the behind those temptations as provided by the Catholic Catechism is great insight into God's rationale.
Jesus, driven by the Spirit, goes into the desert to live in solitude for 40 days.
At the close of that period of prayer and fasting, the devil arrives to attempt to compromise Jesus' filial devotion to God his Father. Satan tempts Jesus three times, and Jesus rebuffs him three times. This is a recapitulation of Satan's seduction of Adam. Only this time, he loses to the new Adam. It is also a recapitulation of Israel in the desert, when the Hebrews forgot God during their 40-year sojourn. In contrast, Jesus is totally obedient to his Father's will. Jesus' victory over temptation is a prelude to his victory over sin on the cross. This is Peggy Stanton, and this has been the Order of Malta's Minute with the Catechism.
This month, the EWTN home video highlight is the sacred